Welcome to Frederick P. Rose Hall, the House of Swing. This is the home of jazz at Lincoln Center, and we're happy that you're choosing to spend your evening in our home. So be at home. Feel free to express yourselves. Now, you know why you're here. We're here for good music, always. This is the House of Swing. Prepare yourselves. We look at four titans in music tonight, four titans of jazz. Please welcome to the Rose Theater stage the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra with Wynton Marsalis.
Thank you very, very much. We're very happy to see you. We ended a swing tonight. We're gonna hear from four titans who reached across the Americas and the African diaspora for inspiration and thematic substance in their quest to develop their own musical worlds and enrich the total substance of jazz, and that's what they did. Now, these great musicians share a common bond, and that bond is Duke Ellington. Mingus, when he was a young band leader just starting out, he took the name Baron Mingus. Okay, there you go. He played in Duke's orchestra in 1953, and he had the distinction of being one of the few musicians that the maestro actually had to let go. Duke normally didn't tell you anything. He just was quiet, and another person who played your instrument would just show up and start playing beside you. And eventually, you just left. He recorded Money Jungle with Duke in 1962 with the great Max Roach. Dizzy Gillespie said an early film of Duke Ellington's band, seeing them clean and being opposite of the type of minstrel material he always saw, convinced him to become a serious jazz musician. 1959, great album Jazz Party. Dizzy is playing on that does unbelievable recording of Billy Strayhorn's Upper Manhattan Medical Group. Bless you. In 1960, he recorded a homage album to Duke called A Portrait of Duke Ellington. Fantastic album, Dizzy. Then, of course, Coltrane. Coltrane made a great recording with Duke in 1962, and it's called Duke Ellington and John Coltrane. Now, we're going to start with Charles Mingus's music. He created a way of playing that incorporated all of the styles of jazz that existed before him. It stretched from New Orleans music to the avant-garde. He didn't believe in segregating himself from anything in our music. This first piece was arranged by our former trombonist, Mr. Ron Westray. It comes from an album released in 1962 on RCA called Tijuana Moods, but it had really been recorded in 1957. The first piece is entitled Dizzy Moods, and that's because all of these gentlemen loved each other and they loved to listen to each other's music, and Mingus based this piece on a song that Dizzy Gillespie arranged for Woody Herman and Woody Herman's big band, and that was called Woody and You. And we're all connected in some way. I met Woody Herman when I was in high school at a gig, and I was the only black person at the gig. And he looked at me and said, "Son, why are you here?" I said, "My father is a piano player, Ellis Marsalis." He said, "Save the music, son." He didn't know me from Adam. I was like, "Okay, yes, sir." I don't know why I even told y'all that story, but it's true. I didn't make it up. I didn't make it up. We hope you enjoy this, Dizzy Moods. Ted Nash. Ali Jackson. Carlos Enriquez, making it feel right. Now, Duke Ellington was the American bard of the 20th century. Recorded over 800 albums, 2,000 songs. And each one is better than the last one you heard. 50 years of unprecedented, relentless development, just kept working on stuff. He tinkered with his music all the time. This next piece that we're gonna play was written during his first tour of Central and South America in 1968. It was recorded in New York City when they returned from the tour. Duke was always someone who liked to travel around and meet musicians and hear the local music and get the local flavor and let the music settle, and then when he got home, he would write some music that reminded him of that feeling, and he translated. He didn't want to be accused of parodying stuff and creating, trying to be nice but creating a bad experience. And sometimes you do that. And if you don't know the people from the culture well enough, they won't tell you. They just go, oh, don't invite them back. They're very disrespectful. Now for this piece, he combined the Afro-Latin habanero rhythm, doom, 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 but doom. You hear that music all over the world. He combined it with the blues. Duke always liked to say, I dress the blues up in their Sunday's finest. It's Acapulco spelled backwards from the Latin American suite. We hope you enjoy Oklupaca. Thank you. That was Walter Blanding. You know him. Dan Nimmer on the piano. I would like to play another piece from Tijuana Moods. I think it's evocative of the type of colorful behavior that takes place on the border, United States-Mexican border town. It's inspired by a trip that he took to Tijuana in the tradition of Yankee Dollar, purchase a good time. This is entitled Tijuana Gift Shop. Let's see what Minkus is talking about.
Thank you. Carlos Enriquez. Vincent Gardner. Marcus Prenta.
Now, Duke had a 50-year love affair with the song Tiger Rag. It was on the first recording of jazz, original Dixieland jazz band. Has the same chord changes as Happy Birthday. Louis Armstrong loved to play Tiger Rag. Duke recorded it at the very beginning of his career in the early 20s. And he recorded it at the very end of his career, so on his last album, actually. This piece we're about to play is another reworking of the harmonic progression, Tiger Rag. But it appeared on a 1965 Reprise album. Reprise was Frank Sinatra's record label. It was Frank's label, and he hired Duke to be the A&R man. So you know they weren't gonna last long. Too much good taste. This album was entitled Concert. It is entitled Concert in the Virgin Islands, but it actually was recorded right down here in the studio on 49th Street. And this is a bossa nova entitled. Okay, I see you're not listening to me, but it's okay. No one is, it's all right. This is a bossa nova. That's not what, it's what the description of it. It's entitled Island Virgin. That's who it's about. But it wasn't the same after the band left. Thank you.
Ted Nash on the piccolo.
Now we'd like to play another piece from Tijuana Moods. It's inspired by the street musicians in Tijuana. Ironically, this piece takes us into various moods from the 4/4 swing that great American historian Jeff Ward loved so much, to the Afro-American church that Lola West enjoys, to the calypso that everybody likes, but no hints of Mexico anywhere. Like Duke, however, Mingus just didn't believe in parroting the styles of other cultures' music. He would interpret the feeling of their music into his language. But he might have been talking about this beautiful solo trumpet that Marcus Prinnup is going to play as an example of the mariachis. Let's see.
Thank you. Thank you.
Carlos Enriquez. Dan Nimmer. Elliot Mason. Marcus Printup. Chris Crenshaw. And the rest of us. Thank you very much. The earliest parts of 1940s is considered to be a miraculous period of Ellingtonia. He produced so many great pieces. The band was called the Blanton Webster Band because Jimmy Blanton, young bassist, died from tuberculosis at a very young age. He came into the band. That's one of the examples where Duke just had two bass players for a little while. And then one of them left, and Jimmy Blanton was left. Ben Webster came into the group playing tenor saxophone. He was the first great tenor saxophone soloist that Duke's band had. Somebody likes Ben, go ahead. That was back when if you looked like any animal, you had no chance with your nickname. So they called him Frog. Anybody looked a certain way when he was playing Honey Bear, they had Frog, they had Rabbit, everybody, the animal kingdom was covered in every jazz band. Now, there are many masterpieces from this period, but we're going to play, to conclude the first half, a barn burner in the Congo rhythm, and it's entitled The Flaming Sword. The other half of that, of the 78 when it was released, was called Warm Valley. So Duke always had his mind on the most basic and important priorities that we have out here on Earth. Please welcome Mr. Bobby Allende to come out and play the congas for us. Anyway, every time Bobby sits down by any instrument, an act of soul is committed. So we hope you enjoy this. This is The Flaming Sword. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much. Chris Crenshaw. Vincent Gardner. Marcus Printup. The clarinet section. Victor Goins, Ted Nash, Paul Netzella, Sherman Irby, Walter Blandy, Bobby Allende on the congas. We are the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. Thank you very, very much. We're going to take a little intermission and we'll be right back. Thank you.